Welcome to No Man's Sky Permadeath mode. In the last part, we built our science terminal in here, but we need to recruit a scientist, and we obtained the technology to build a hyperdrive, and we built the hyperdrive. Now it's time to go out and take a leap into the void, and what I'm going to do is go and collect this plutonium over here, because there's a possibility we may not be coming back to this planet, and I might as well take the plutonium with me. And we need to stock up on some plutonium, a little bit of iron. Just watch out for that sentinel. I don't want to antagonize him. So what we're going to do is stock up on a few resources, and then I'm going to visit a couple of bases on this planet with free takeoff and landings. Let's throw out a scan, see what's around it. There's some thamium over there. I think we'll go and get the thamium. If my memory serves me correctly, we've then got to get the... Or I don't think it's the former. I think we get one free antimatter to go out and explore the universe with. Not much of a start. We've got to jump at least once to get to the antimatter formula. If I'm a... Oh, bugger. Don't want this. I think we can send both Fatmians to the ship. That should free up a bit of space. Grab this. Kind of stocking up a little bit too much on thamium, but we might need it. We need a bit of iron, if I remember correctly. I had a look before I started. Yeah, we don't have any iron. Got some mordite. Probably get rid of that, and we might sell it, actually. If we can find a base for a terminal. If not, we'll just dump it. So we'll go and grab a little bit of iron. I think that should be... Yeah, that's iron there. This is where having a grenade or plasma launcher, I think is the correct term for it. I prefer to call it a grenade launcher. It's 25, not brilliant. I think if we do some walking collection, grab a bit more iron. God, I'd be glad to get a decent multi-tool. It's when you start a new game, you really appreciate the later tech, realize how wimpy your ship is and what your multi-tool is when you actually do this. Right, so let's get into the flying brick. As I say, what I'm going to do is fly across the surface. That should be the... Oops, we're a bit... That's all our plutonium. We've only got one takeoff. We're going to have to be a bit careful. That's the message that basically tells us where to get the antimatter. And it's invariably normally on another planet. So it's out that way somewhere. Yeah, there it is up there. Probably back on that planet with the hostile sentinels. I think we'll fly this way then. We'll get off in the right direction. Oh, come on. You've got a bit more info than that. As I say, I'd like to visit a couple of bases. There's one. I don't think that's a base. I think that's just... that's just a minor base. We've got to land somewhere where there's a free takeoff and landing, because we can't afford to consume plutonium. We're going to need that. There's a free base here. We're certainly going to land on this. I think I might have already visited this, but we can sell off that mordite. And any other junk that we've got. Oh no, this might be a free... Oh, this could be very handy. And let's see what we can sell. It's very, very small amounts of income, but... I don't even want that. I think we'll sell the Antrium and the Mordite. Let's say it's not a vast amount, but you've got to take it where you can find it. Of course, what we're going to go is we're certainly going to buy some plutonium. That's... And some zinc. I think we're okay for thamium. I've got to stay above 10,000, because if we find a drop pod, The first expansion costs 10,000 and it increases by 10,000 each one. Hello, Mr. Geck. Give if off a fox. Oh, give him some carbon. Ah, oh, yes, yes. Oh no, that's just the upgrade. Bugger. Oh, that's absolutely no good to us without the actual base technology. But what I will do is install this. It's going to be 25 plutonium, 100 iridium, because we might need that to blast through an entrance. Now I've done that, we'll probably get this. It's probably going to cost a fortune. Yeah, 1 point. Yeah, well, 14 slot. That's what I want, is the plasma launcher tech. Oh, well, never mind. We're just going to have to... Of course, we're going to go and check out the other buildings. See what's around here. This is a good find, guys. A very, very good find. Finding something like this, we may get some decent stuff from here. In fact, if it goes really well, I might not bother visiting any other places. There's some plutonium there, we're certainly going to grab that. Let's go in here. No, I'll get a bit of carbon. Not going to turn it down. The Corvax transmission tower. Long ago. So what's that? 4, 5, 4s are 20, 6, 2s. That's 720. Distress signals. Oh. Standing with the Corvax has increased. So that looks like we may have a crashed ship, guys. Now the question is, do I go looking for it? Crash ships in that direction, how far? 6 hours, wow. Is it going to be worth, oops, what the heck happened there? Is it going to be worth traveling that distance, landing and risking some plutonium to actually get a possible crash ship? It would mean I would have to redo the hyperdrive. Where's the entrance to this bloody thing? Oh, there it is. Sorry, apologies, language, guys. That's some plutonium there. We've got a creature creeping up on us as well. Hello, Mr. Geck. Valued customer. Give Tanti. God knows what Tanti is. We'll give you a hunt. It's not that. It's probably titanium. We haven't actually got that. But we'll give him 100 units. He may give us something for it. Yep. So we couldn't answer that anyway. And this is probably going to be a monolith or something. This would be 0978 because it's a sequence of just the numbers shuffling around. Your standing with the Geck has increased. How far away is that? Now if that's within reasonable walking distance, it's going to be a risk. How far away is that? That's 22 minutes walking, that's too far. I'd love to mark this base for future reference if I'm going to stay, but it's plutonium over there. Some plutonium up over there. I think we'll go and collect that. If this is a nice big watch of plutonium, guys, we're going to go and check that ship out. It's going to take what I planned in a totally different direction, but I think it could be worth it, guys. I mean, I'm going to waste 200 plutonium. There's one of those bug creatures there. We're going to go back around this way and work our way this way round. Just heard that on the... There he is. We'll just keep walking this way. Getting twitchy. Sorry, guys. Heart attack in every step. Okay, let's get into here. Let's have a think about this. Health level rises. Yeah, I won't turn that down. We've got plenty of famine for there. We don't have enough plutonium for a takeoff. Okay. There's some plutonium over there. Go and grab that. Got to have enough for at least one takeoff. Any more plutonium around here? How much plutonium have we got now? Got just enough for one takeoff. Right, we're gonna go for it, guys. This could be a complete waste of time. Where's the... Now, to do get here, we're going to have to go up into space. How much iron have I got? Yeah, we got enough for a recharge. Because the only way we're going to get round the planet in that amount of time is by taking off. Going up into space. And then up, 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 up. Get a bit of height. Down. Come on, flying brick. So this is the only way you can really get round a planet to get to a base, something like this. Make it a nice ship, not damaged. This is one of the downsides now with crashed ships. They're often quite badly damaged and therefore you can't repair them, which means that you don't really have the ability. So we may have to reject the ship purely and simply on the grounds that we can't actually repair them. If we can get a bit more speed up. Anyway, I'll see you when I arrive, guys. There's something here. Is there a landing post here? Oh, there's another terminal base here. I think we're gonna land here, guys. Sorry for the digression. Or digression. We can't afford to pass this up. Another double terminal here. We might be able to get some stuff. Just make sure we got exosuit. And we got the space in here, so. Got the plutonium. Got a Geck charm, that's good. Power canister. Lord, Mr. Geck, if I got space in my inventory for you. Nope. I think what we can do is just use the power canister. Recharge our life support. This is probably going to cost another fortune. 3.6, 20, full 24 slot multi-tool. If I just had 3.6 million, one can only dream. Valued customer, get high, rad, friends, high, yeah. Range dry sense. I think the key is probably in dry, so we'll give him some water. Come on, guys. Combat amplifier Sigma. Mining beam companion unit. Well, that could be useful. So we're getting a little bit of tech coming in. Can we, is that working? Yeah, we'll interact with that. Another 225 credits. Is there anything I can sell? I'd rather keep the Geck charm if necessary. Trouble is this is getting my inventory. Actually, I'm going to sell the Geck charm, guys. Sorry. Because if we're going to go for a crash ship, we may not have the space for all this stuff. We got reached the dizzy height of 36,000. Actually, what we could do, buy some more plutonium. No, none for sale, bugger. That's not fair. Okay, let's go look outside. I'm gonna throw out a scan. Some spodonium over there. Like there's some platinum over there, so we'll go and get that. Trouble is, I really need, how much iridium have I got? 84. Don't really have that much iridium. That's going to be a problem, because if I've got to repair the ship, I'm going to need iridium to repair the ship with. So we have to go all the way through that exercise we've done before. Oh bugger. I'd love to check that building out there. I think we can get to it. Grab some carbon. Let's go into the observatory and see what we can find. Plutonium there, so you're going to grab that. Yes, but we'll be okay. We'll be in here. What's the bet this guy's going to ask for a Gek charm? I should have kept it and used it, shouldn't I? Oh, bugger. Sisk. I'm going to pay him 1,000. Sisk is Gek for credits. Light provides a blueprint. I want the thing, I'm getting all the tech round it, but not the one I want. It's not fair. The operations terminal reveals an automated plea. That's 90, so that'd be 353, I guess. Distress signals, got another one, too! I don't believe it. If it's wiped out the original one and I'm now having to go all the way back across the planet to get to that one, I could be really, really miffed. So where's this one? Nah, it's probably the same one actually. Anyway, let's get up on the terminal and... What did you do in this part? I spent all this part chasing chips. Why won't that? No. That says it's an hour away. It's okay. Now it says that it's 9 minutes away. Has that actually got further away? Anyway, guys, I'll see you when I arrive. Have a base there. This one doesn't seem to have a landing peg on it. Oops, a daisy. Can't see whether this base has got. Yes, it's got a 3 landing point on it. Just saw it out the corner of my eye. Oops, and I've just crashed straight into it. If this is another distress one, I'm not going to press it, guys. I'm not going to press it. This is crazy. Absolutely crazy. There's definitely a pop in here. Absolutely nothing in here. Another one over here. We'll check this out. Well, we got another word. Got the Gek word for despair. Got some nanite clusters. And this looks very much like another transmission tower, guys. Right, let's see what this guy wants. What's it full of? Oh, we'll send that to the ship. Hello, Mr. Gek. You're a friend. If you want cash, I haven't got it. Destroy. Caught the trader red-handed. We'll report the crime. Receive a reward. Grenade tech, grenade tech, grenade tech. Life support module Sigma. That's useful, but it's not what I want, guys. This is a Gek observatory, so we can click this. And this is going to be 9210. Success, a new location is revealed to me. Trouble is, it's wiped out the previous one. Or it's sending me to the same one. Right, we're just going to throw out another scan to see if there's anything around. There's going to be some plutonium over here. In theory, we should have plenty of plutonium. Any plutonium? Can I see it? That's a knowledge stone. We're certainly going to get the knowledge stone. And there's some iridium. That's exactly what I want. So what we're going to do is go and gather some iridium. Exosuit. So we're going to go and mine some iridium. Because if we're going to have to repair the ship, we're going to need iridium. This could work out really well, guys. As long as I don't get killed. Is it worth saying that my heart's actually pumping at the moment? How can one get so stressed over a game? Plutonium over there as well. I'm going to go down and get that. If we can grab this before the local sentinels show up. It's not a lot because it's not a complete nodule. It's actually wrapped around a rock. Oh no, it's destroying the rock as well. That's good. Right, guys, I'll see you once I've mined this, because I'm aware that I've actually spent 20 minutes and we haven't actually done anything that I originally intended to do. Right, so we got the iridium. Hopefully we can rely on chance to get the iron. We need to repair the shields. Everything is always broken. So I'll see you when I get to the ship, guys. Right, guys, here we are. We're approaching the crashed ship. It looks like it's just on the other side of this rise here. It's around here somewhere. If it's not, I'm going to be really, really annoyed. Probably a bit too far away. I probably landed a bit prematurely. Yeah. Oh, come on, please do me a favor, guys. Do me a favor. You're not damaged. Oh, I'm not going to be able to transfer anything, am I? I'm going to have to dump a lot of stuff to get into this. This isn't fair for a one slot ship. That is not fair. Not fair in any shape, form, or description, guys. that is sickening. Okay, we're just gonna have to. Moral of the story is, when you're starting out in the game, crash ships are a bit of a waste of time. and I've just wasted your time, my time, chasing down a crash ship. Chain of the cargo, find a black box. Respect for recently insured ship tech. Laser. I scan its blueprint, I construct it for myself. Advanced cooling Sigma. Right, guys, now the next thing I've got to do is get out of here without consuming too much in the way of resources. I think I can walk up here. I'm pissed, guys. I am really, really pissed. I've wasted time, I've wasted resources to get nothing. And I think that's a key lesson. Where's my ship? That's over there. Oh, I'm gonna get some zinc. Certainly gonna get that. We got any spare slots? Make sure we got some spare slots. We can send that. I suppose it's not a total loss. What's that there? That zinc. Oh, we got two zinc plants. I'm cheering up a little bit now, guys. Think we're gonna check out this area. See if there's anything around here that's. I don't want to fall off the top of there. That's a dead cert. See if there's anything around here that will justify looking. Let's throw out a scan. Anything around here? There's some nanites down there. Or probably on the other side of this hill. We'll go and get that. Might as well grab the nanites while we can. No, it must be on the other side. I'm not going to walk all the way around. If it was down here, I'd be okay. Grab a bit of carbon. Our mining beam's getting a bit low. Life support. No, I don't want life support. I want this. Might as well recharge that. Right, guys. I think all I can do in this part is sit in the corner and cry. Let's have a look at what we got. Well, we got enough for another takeoff, so we haven't lost that much. I'm a bit more optimistic now. We haven't lost, we've learnt a key lesson. I think what I am going to do though is do at least part of what I said I was going to do. Certainly top up that. And what we're going to do is we're going to go out. And we're in space. What we're going to do now, how long that's. We need to get to the space station all there, but the trouble is, I think what we're going to do is fly, see if we can fly along the upper surface at the moment. Question is, can I hop to that space station? Okay, we're gonna go for it, guys. 33 seconds. We'll go for the space station and then we'll go for the outpost. Oh, should we go straight for the outpost? If the scan doesn't start by the time I pass the space station, we'll go straight for the outpost, guys. So you can at least see something of what I intended to do in this part. We're flying upside down now. Can I land upside down? Please correct my ship for me. Now, in theory, if I remember correctly, it's a little while since I've started a No Man's Sky series, but this should be where our first free antimatter is, and it should be a free landing. Famous last words. So we're just going to fly towards the outpost and I'll see you when we get there, guys. Of course, this is the planet with the hostile sentinels if you've been watching the series. Now this should be a free. That's a trading post. That's nice. No iron around though. That's going to be a little bit difficult. We need to restock up a little bit on iron before I leave. I should have stocked up more. Yes, I know. Oh. And if I got any space in my suit. And what this happy guy should give us is the three antimatter. Except for Atlas, find a new system, look for anomaly. We take the antimatter. I'm no wiser as to who Nada and Polo are, but we have the means to locate them. Yes. So we've now got antimatter, and what we should be able to do is not. That's a craft, what am I on about? Is make a warp sail now. And if I put that into the hyperdrive, that gives us one free jump. Now the game's very curious. I'll just click here to show you. What you actually get is you get the electron vapor, but you don't get the antimatter formula, you don't get the suspension fluid formula. So you get the one in the middle, which is a bit weird really. And I think, I suppose if we talk to this guy, he's gonna want a Gek relic or something like that. Or a, yeah, Gek nip, Gek charm. Check the multi-tool, another very expensive multi-tool, yep, 2.8 million. Probably when I've got the money, they won't be around anymore. They'll probably be junky ones. Any free, there's some free stuff out here. Maybe a Gek relic or something out here. Some plutonium there, we're certainly going to grab that. As long as we don't get killed by the... Go away, go away, go away, go away. We can go and sell the fascination bead. Sell items from your inventory. We'll sell that. We'll get a bit of cash. Don't think there's anything else we can sell. I think I want to keep the Corvax convergence cube because we're going to go looking for a Corvax. So that could be useful. They're deactivated. Some a bit damaged. Exosuit. You can go to there. That gives us a bit of space. I think we're just going to leg it over to here. And get in here. Got some more nanite clusters. There's a sentinel hanging around over there. And I think what we're going to do is run round here to this one. There's some little bit of iron hanging around there, so we might be able to grab the iron. Hopefully we'll do it before the sentinel comes in. Grab some more iron. And then we can duck back inside this building if the... Grab a bit more. And we'll just hide back in here for a little while, guys. How much iron have I got now? Got 122 in the exosuits. But nothing, so we got 122 iron. Really could do with a little bit more. That's carbon, great. So we can grab the iron, grab this, and then we'll try and get out of here as quickly as possible. Right guys, what we're going to do is we're going to leg it around this base to the ship and get into here. Oh. And what I'd like to do is try and get that plutonium. Well, I bet you it's out of range. Yeah, we'll grab that plutonium. And there's a sentinel coming in. We're going to jump in there. I'm going to take a deep breath. And we've got a free takeoff. And what I'm going to do is... We're going to head for the space station, and then that will be the end for this part, guys. I can find the space station. Oh, come on. Don't do this to me, guys. Where is the space station? Are we on the wrong side? Oh, there it is. This is an hour away. Okay. 12 seconds, 12 seconds, 12 seconds. Yeah, they've started to scan. But we should make it as long as we can find the entrance. Yeah, we're on the right side for the entrance. Whew. I think, I don't know about you, but I need a break. This is quite stressful. I wanted to get as much of this done as possible. As I say, this is where I'm going to leave it. Hope you've enjoyed the episode. The next part, we will start our journey across the galaxy. So until then, guys, whatever you do, enjoy your gaming.